This video is designed for beginners who want to learn how to get started with a multimeter. The idea for this video was inspired by Mr. Piotr Górecki, a well-known writer and electronics enthusiast from Poland. Some parts of this content are based on his insights, and if you'd like to explore more, you can find a link in the description to his full article. A multimeter is an essential tool, especially in today's homes where many devices rely on electricity. Modern multimeters, like the ones that you can see here, are quite advanced and yet are affordable. Some even come with additional features such as temperature measurement. I, for example, use this function a lot in the kitchen to measure the temperature of the water for the yeast, for example. With basic understanding, you can use a multimeter to diagnose issues with household appliances, you can check the tools, or even car batteries. Thanks to these extra features, multimeters go far and beyond just measuring voltage. However, a word of caution, do not work with high voltages unless you are properly trained. If you are unsure, don't attempt it. Multimeters measure electricity, they do not protect you from it. As the name implies, a multimeter measures multiple electrical quantities, primarily voltage, current, and resistance. The typical layout of a multimeter is that on the top we have the display for displaying the measurement. In the middle we have the dial to switch the functions and function buttons. And at the bottom we have the terminals for the probes. The black one goes to the common and the red one goes to, depending on what we are measuring. Voltage and current are measured differently. Voltage is measured in parallel with the load and current is measured in series with the load. And the load refers to any device drawing power from the source, like a lamp, a toaster, an oven, or a hairdryer. Well, you get it. Some multimeters require not only selecting the function, but also manually setting the measurement range, just like on this one, on the PeakTech 2005A, which we made a video about it if you want to check it later. Anyways, if you are unsure of the value you will be measuring, it is safest to start with the highest range and then work downward for accuracy. Experienced users often prefer manual range selection for speed and consistency, especially when you are repeating the same measurements. Auto-ranging multimeters perform a similar task, automatically adjusting the range from highest to the lowest until the correct range is found. This process may take a few seconds, but it allows one-hand operation. Fortunately, many modern multimeters like Brymen one here, yes, they come with both, with automatic and manual range modes. You can explore more options at tme.eu. We have a lot of multimeters there to offer, and not only at TME, you'll find hundreds of thousands of products with trusted brands like Brymen, like Fluke, like Owon, like PeakTech. And if you order it right now, probably your order will be fulfilled in less than 24 hours because 96% of the orders are fulfilled the same day. So check it out. At the back of many multimeters, you will find a foldable stand. This is exactly how they are standing. And if I do this, they are not standing, sorry. Anyways, we also have the probe holders, a hook or a place for a hook for hands-free operation. So you don't need to actually hold the multimeter while you are testing some stuff. You can just hang it and both of your hands are going to be free. You also have access to the battery compartment and, very important, fuses. These components protect both you and the device in case of improper use or unexpected faults. Many of those faults are, of course, because of human. Batteries are can be in many types. Some use a 9-volt battery, others use 2 AA or even 3 AAA batteries. Always use fresh batteries, as low batteries levels can lead to misleading and malfunctioned readings, and sometimes even the it just won't work. Guys, use fresh batteries for accurate measurements. It's not uncommon to accidentally blow a fuse by forgetting to switch the terminals. It's a common mistake, just make sure you learn from it. The best way to demonstrate how to measure with a multimeter is with an example. If hello world is the simplest example for coding, then turning a light bulb is the equivalent one, for sure. So let's use a simple circuit with a power source, a resistor and an LED to demonstrate how to measure voltage, current and resistance. This is something that I did 5 minutes ago, I don't know. Anyways, voltage is measured between two points as we already mentioned and it is in parallel with the components and we can measure in this circuit the voltage across the power source, across the LED and across the resistor. The sum of the voltages across the LED and the resistor is going to be equal to what? Exactly, to the supply voltage. If you're measuring a battery or accumulator and find the voltage is significantly lower than its rated value, it's likely you need to be replacing. Replacing means that you need to recycle it. For example, a 12-volt battery readings around 2 volts DC is nearly dead. So far we have covered DC voltage. For AC voltage, which are found in the mains outlet, safety is crucial. Select the AC voltage function on your multimeter and, as Mr. Górecki advises, to minimize the risk of electric shock, it is worth taking measurements with one hand. This way there is no possibility that due to user error, current will flow between two hands through the heart. Very bad. Moreover, miners and beginners should only perform work under circuits where dangerous voltage is presented under supervision of qualified supervisors. When measuring voltage over 100 volts, especially in power grid applications, always stay focused and cautious. It is advised to have a second person present who knows how to respond in case of emergency, including disconnecting power quickly. Current measurements, or as Mr. Górecki says, current intensity measurements, require inserting the multimeter in series with the circuit. In our example, where we have the 5 volts from the power supply, the 330 ohms resistance and the 3 volts forward voltage of the LED, if we are going to use the Ohm's law and calculate that the current is about 6 milliamps. But without the resistor, the remaining 2 volts are dropped directly across the LED. With assuming that the internal resistance is around 10 ohms, the current could spike up 200 milliamps. This level is far beyond safe operation and will almost certainly destroy and kill and damage the LED. It's a kaput. But how do you know that this resistor is 330 ohms? Well, trained individuals can read the color bands and just tell by seeing it. But until then, you can measure it with your multimeter. Measurements should be done with the circuit part off. Place the probe across the resistor to check its value. Very low resistance means that the material is conductive and this is referred to as a continuity test. The multimeter will indicate continuity often with a sound or even a blinking screen or visual symbol. This is useful for checking whether the connection is intact or broken. Pro tip, use 2mm crocodile clips on your probes for better contact and safety. And that's everything for now. All the tools or the equipment that you have seen in this episode are available at our website tme.eu. If you have any questions or need any help, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section and see you in the next episode. Okay, a lot of it is going to be voiceover. Actually, the whole thing is going to be voiceover. I don't know why we planned this. This is... Okay. All right.